Okay, so the 30-60-90 triangle is a little more difficult than the 45-45-90 because there's not just two rules. On the 30-60-90 triangle, the 30 degree angle, the side across from it, which is called the short leg, is the most important leg. So if you're given the short leg, that's the easiest type of problem because you can easily find the hypotenuse and long leg from the short leg. If you're given the hypotenuse or the long leg, you're going to have to find the short leg first. You can't just go between the long leg and the hypotenuse directly. You'll go through the way of the short leg. And so there's two relationships, but four operations that come from those two relationships. So if you're given the short leg and you're going to the long leg, you're going to multiply by two. If we're going to the long leg, we're going to multiply by the square root of three. Not sure why I wrote it like that. Okay, so short leg to long leg, multiply by the square root of three. So if you're going from the long leg to the short leg, you're going to do the opposite. You're going to divide by the square root of three. If you're going from the short leg to the hypotenuse, you're going to just multiply by 2. So if you're going from the hypotenuse to the short leg, you're going to do the opposite. You're going to divide by 2. So there's actually four different operations that you can do. You're either going to be multiplying or dividing by the square root of 3, or multiplying or dividing by the square root of 2. So both of these are 30-60-90 triangles because I'm given a 90 here and a 60. That means this one has to be 30. Here I'm given the 90 and the 30, which means this one has to be the 60. So make sure you understand which side you're given here. I'm given the side across from the 30-degree angle. That's my short leg. And I'm asked to find the side across from the 60, which is the long leg, and the side across from the 90, which is the hypotenuse. So remember, this is the easiest type. If I'm given the short leg, I can go directly to the hypotenuse by doubling it. So 6 times 2 means my hypotenuse is 12. So y is 12. I can also go directly to the long leg from the short leg by just multiplying by the square root of 3. 6 times the square root of 3 is 6 square roots of 3. So my long leg is 6 square roots of 3. Now over here, on part C, we're given the side across from the 60. We're given the long leg. We have to find the side across from the 30, which is the short leg, and the side across from the 90, which is the hypotenuse. So remember, you're always going to go by way of the short leg. So I'm going to go from the long leg to the short leg first. And remember, this is not the 2-to-1 relationship. So a lot of common mistakes, the students see that 12 and they put a 6 here. There's not a 2-to-1 relationship between the two legs. It's between the short leg and the hypotenuse. So to go from the long leg to the short leg, we're going from something bigger to something smaller. So we're going to divide, but we're not dividing by 2. We're dividing by the square root of 3. And so we have to rationalize that denominator, multiplying the numerator and the denominator by the square root of 3. So I'd have 12 square roots of 3 in the numerator, and the square root of 3 times the square root of 3 is simply 3. You always want to simplify that. Remember, these threes can't cancel because one's under a radical and one's not. But I can simplify 12 divided by 3, which is 4. So I get 4 square roots of 3 for my short leg, which is Q. There's not a blank there, but I'll make one. That's 4 square roots of 3. Now I can go from the short leg to the hypotenuse. Remember, that's the 2-to-1 relationship. So if you're going from something smaller to something bigger, you're multiplying. So I'm simply taking the 4 square roots of 3 and multiplying it by 2. Remember, only the numbers outside multiply together. Don't double what's under the radical. So this is 8 square roots of 3 for the hypotenuse. So 8 square roots of 3. So there's some examples to help you with your homework tonight. And we'll actually spend 2 days on this, so we'll be looking at some more problems like these tomorrow. See you then.